In this video, you will learn to create box plots using StatCrunch. The data set I will be using in this video is called Asking Prices for 4 Bedroom Homes in Bryan, College Station, Texas. This data set compares 4 bedroom homes listed for sale in the 2 adjoining cities, Bryan, Texas, and College Station, Texas. It consists of a random sample of 15 homes listed for sale in Bryan and 15 homes listed for sale in College Station. The square foot column contains the square footage of each home, and the location column lists the city where the home is located. For this example, I'm interested in comparing the square footage column of the 4 bedroom homes listed for sale in Bryan to those of College Station. To do that, I will begin by constructing box plots grouped by column. Under the graph menu, choose box plot. I'm going to select the square footage column, and then in the group by box, I'll choose location. Go ahead and click compute. The resulting box plots display the 5 number summary for each location. In our box plot, the outliers are not identified. To identify the outliers, we need to modify our box plot. To do so, under options, choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we built our box plots. In the window, StatCrunch allows the user to customize their box plot. Under the Other options, I'm going to check Use Fences to Identify Outliers. I'll click Compute. The modified box plots are now shown, and notice there is an outlier indicated for Bryan, Texas. If we click and drag to highlight the outlier, the corresponding row in the data table is now highlighted. This highlighting can be cleared at any time using the Clear button in the bottom left-hand corner. StatCrunch also allows the user to draw the box plots horizontally instead of vertically. To do so, go back under Options, choose Edit. Mark the option that says Draw Boxes Horizontally. Click Compute. The resulting box plots are now shown with a horizontal orientation with the numerical scale on the x-axis.